Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and this is our last video concerning the upper limb, and we are finishing with the distalmost muscles, which are the muscles of the hand, specifically the muscles that will both originate and insert in the hand. So not those forearm muscles that extend that way. So we'll talk about two of the compartments that are on the medial and lateral side, and then we'll finish off with some of the smaller sets of muscles, the lumbricals and the interossei. Okay, so two of the larger areas when we're talking about the intrinsic muscles of the hand are associated on the thenar, or the lateral side, and the hypothenar, or the medial side. So thenar is going to be associated with the first digit. And if you look at the palm of your own hand, you'll see that you'll have kind of a bulge of muscle just deep to the skin. And you are looking, if you're looking at the thumb region, and you're looking at the thenar compartment there. And then on the opposite side, on the medialmost side, you will have the hypothenar compartment. And you can see some of those deeper muscles if you were to reflect some of those. So the opponent's muscles are going to be on the deeper compartments or part of the compartments here. So these will play a role in terms of really moving a lot of those fine movements associated with both the first digit and the fifth digit. And you can see that both will have these opponents muscles that will play a role in terms of opposition, which is that compound movement whereby you can move the first digit kind of close to the fifth digit, if you think about an opposable thumb, something unique in terms of primates. That's what we're talking about there. The thenar muscle, or muscles of the thenar compartment, are going to be innervated by the median nerve, which is kind of unique in this area because most of the muscles of the hand, of the intrinsic hand, will be innervated by the ulnar nerve, which is true of the hypothenar compartment. So thenar, again, is median nerve, similar to most of those muscles of the anterior forearm, but the rest are mostly ulnar nerve. Now, still looking at the palmar anterior view, again, here's that here's the thenar compartment, and here is the hypothenar compartment. And coming in through the carpal tunnel, recall that we had tendons of the flexor digitorum superficialis as well as the profundus. And so those are heading all the way to the phalanges. And attaching on the flexor digitorum profundus tendons within the hand, you're going to have these kind of worm-shaped muscles that are literally attaching to the tendons of flexor digitorum profundus called the lumbricals. And so you're going to have four lumbricals. You can see them numbered here. And these will have kind of a separate innervation as well. The more medial ones will be innervated by the ulnar, and the more lateral ones will be innervated by the median nerve. So it's only these two lateral most lumbricals as well as the thenar compartment that are innervated by the median nerve. All the rest is ulnar nerve, all the rest of the muscles. Now these muscles will, when they contract, will play a role in terms of flexing the MP joints. So kind of think of flexing your MP joints. You're kind of putting all your fingers on your palm. And they will also extend the interphalangeal joints. And it does this because the tendon of the lumbricals are going to attach to the extensor expansion, which plays a role in terms of extension of the digits. So that is how you're getting that that extension and kind of an opposite movement from the flexion. And it's because of that distal attachment on the extensor expansions. The interossei are going to have similar movements as to what we just described for the lumbricals, in addition to some other ones. And you have both dorsal and palmar interossei. You have three palmar interossei, which are located on, as the name would suggest, more of the palmar side or the anterior side. And then you have four dorsal interossei, which are located more on the posterior side. And I know in this image it looks a bit like we have a hand and we have a finger that is kind of flipping us off, and that is not why the illustrator chose to have it like this. It's because this third digit, which you can see extended in these images, is the number digit by which the fingers will abduct and adduct. So recall, in typical abduction and adduction, think shoulder joint, hip joint, that's moving away from the midline. And when we think of midline, we're thinking it kind of going right down the thorax. But that's not the same for abduction and adduction when we're talking about the hand or the foot. And so they're either moving away from or towards a certain digit. And when we're talking about the hand, it will be the third digit. So the palmar interossei will adduct, which means that would have these other digits moving towards that third digit, whereas the dorsal interossei will abduct, so away from the third digit. Okay? So, and when we talk about this, we're specifically talking about digits 2 through 4. Recall that first digit kind of has its own muscles that are going to play a role there. Fifth digit as well. Sometimes you can still see it described as playing a role for the fifth digit. So you have this nice, lovely mnemonic here, dab and pad. So dorsal interossei abduct and palmar interossei adduct. So towards or away from that third digit. And like most of the intrinsic muscles of the hand, this is going to be innervated by the ulnar nerve. Okay, so real quick review here. Which nerve will innervate the intrinsic hand muscles? Is it the median nerve? Is it the median nerve and radial nerve? Is it musculocutaneous? Is it ulnar nerve and medial nerve? Or just the ulnar nerve? Okay. So hopefully this kind of just jumps out at you. We kept going over and over again about how the ulnar nerve is one of the main supplies of the intrinsic hand muscles. So I need to hone in on these answer choices that have ulnar nerve in it. If it doesn't have ulnar nerve in it, it's certainly not right, because that's doing the majority. But, and I have medial here, that would make this wrong. I meant to have this be an N. But this is what I was trying to go for here. Ulnar nerve and median nerve, not medial. You see people say that incorrectly all the time, and here I go saying it incorrectly, or typing it incorrectly here. So the correct answer is going to be ulnar nerve and median nerve, not medial nerve. So recall that thenar compartment, as well as a few of the lumbricals, will be innervated by the median nerve, while all the rest of the intrinsic hand muscles are the ulnar nerve. So this wouldn't be correct either, because we don't want to forget that important contribution, particularly with the thenar compartment. Radial nerve, no way. That's posterior compartments of the arm and the forearm. It will play a role in terms of sensory innervation of the posterior hand, but not in terms of efferent or motor innervation or causing muscle contraction. And the musculocutaneous will be the anterior compartment of the arm. So incorrect as well. Okay, so that wraps us up for the upper limb. Now we're going to move into our last set of lectures, or sets of lectures, which will be focused on the lower limb. The great thing about the lower limb is that a lot of the themes that we've just discussed in terms of the upper limb will apply to the lower limb. So we'll have lumbricals, we'll have interossei, we'll have phalanges. So there will be a lot of similarities in that region as well. So, fun times. We're getting into locomotion. I can't wait to get into it, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you for your time.